everybody, and welcome to another roundup of the best mobile marketing strategies, tips and news from around the web. Okay, let's get right into it. First of all, I would like to share something that is quite interesting, I thought, especially for you bookstore owners out there. I saw on this particular website a very interesting way of using QR codes. Obviously, they have been very creative. As a small business owner, we all know you should really be using QR codes as part of your local marketing strategy, and in a creative way, if possible. Now, some bookstores use QR codes in quite a creative way, as you will see on this particular webpage. When consumers go to some bookstores, they will find a QR code with a catchy line on the cover of the book saying, "Scan here for the ebook version of this release." It may be that the hard copy is out of stock, but what tends to happen is that the ebook is offered at half the price. So often consumers leave, which you may think is bad for a storekeeper. Not really, because the storekeeper gets a small fee for every ebook sold, as the QR codes are embedded with the geolocation software. So maybe you can think of a creative way to use QR code marketing for your small business. Let us know what you've come up with. It's always great if you could share it here with us. Let's have a look at the next information I would like to share with you guys. On this particular site, it's called Geeks and Nerds Online, and they share with us quite an interesting article. We all know that SMS marketing is a very effective way for getting consumers coming through our doors fast or build rapport with them. But when done incorrectly, it can hurt your marketing efforts and ultimately your business too. So here are the five common marketing mistakes you should try to avoid. First of all, you need to know the rules. I think that probably speaks for itself. Secondly, target wisely. Always make sure to personalize your message. Thirdly, don't overdo it. Don't start bombarding your customers with messages, because they will ultimately asking not to receive any further messages. Number four, have a clear call to action. Visit the website, coupon code for discounts, etc. And number five, mobile friendly websites. If not, people really will lose interest very fast, and obviously you lose a potential sale. Okay, on our next topic, we go to Mobile Marketing Association. Now, they are talking about a new app that's come out, which I thought was quite interesting. I wanted to share with you. It's a mobile marketing tool for businesses. This new app widget, which is created by Fun Mobility, provides the power to send rich content and promotions via standard push alerts. Segment and target users, analyze results, and optimize the user engagement loop, all in real time. It's also very easy to implement for users and can be done on the fly whenever you want to, and it's really great for customizable user experience. If I scroll a little bit lower down, you can see they have a great video they want to share with you. So if you really want to find out a little bit more about this, this video will explain everything in great detail. And so, as usual, all the information discussed today, all the web pages I mentioned, there will be a link to the content below the video in the description, so you can have a read of it in your own time. Get all the full details, watch the video, they're really interesting. Also, this brings us then to the end of this latest roundup of the best mobile marketing tips, strategies and news from around the web. Please be so kind just to help us and small business owners. Please like this video. You could also share this video. And the other thing I would love you to do is to leave a comment, as I will personally see to it that I respond to all comments you leave below. I hope you enjoyed this latest episode today. If you have any further questions or you need help with your mobile marketing for your small business, please visit inofarmarketing.com. www.ecosystemsolutions.co.uk. This brings us to the end of this latest installment. I hope you enjoyed it and hopefully see you soon on the next episode. Thank you. Bye.